In this video, we will learn how to test our application using containers, Docker, and Postman. We'll test a simple CRUD application that uses Node.js, Express, and Postgres. Let's get started. First of all, let's clone the application. So git clone, and I leave a link in the description. And then we can open this with any IDE we want, for example, Visual Studio Code. And we should have something like that. We'll not go into the details. If you want, you can check the previous video. We need to change only one line of code, because here in the docker-compose.yml file, we are building the image. We don't want to build it. We will just use this image, which is public. Let's open a terminal and let's type docker-compose-app-d, which stands for detached node underscore db. This is the service that runs the Postgres container. And now the application, docker compose app dash d node underscore app. Nice. Let's check if the containers are up and running, docker ps dash a. Yes, and we can check if the application is running correctly using Postman. We can just make an HTTP request, localhost 3000. We should get a hello world here, and we can get the users. We don't have any user. This is not the goal of this video. We are just testing endpoints. Now we need to deploy our application. How can you deploy our application? We can use different cloud providers, but for this example, I want to use something which is free. Play with Docker. This uses a technology called Docker in Docker, and we have basically a public instance where we can deploy our application. Here we have a public instance with a public IP for free for 4 hours. Don't use this in production. And here, to deploy our application, we can just copy paste our Docker Compose file inside this folder. We can copy paste like this, or we can use SSH. Now we can use the same two commands that we did before. So docker compose app dash d node underscore db. It downloads the Postgres image from Docker Hub, and it runs a Postgres service container based on that image. We're using the same docker compose file that we had here. And now the node application, docker compose app dash d node underscore app, and it pulls the Francesco's image of the node application from Docker Hub. That image is public. Docker ps dash a, and we have the two services up and running. Now let's test them, but on a public IP. Can you see here we have the two ports that are open, 3000 and 5432, which is for the Postgres one. If we open this on a new tab, can you see we have the hello world, but this IP is public. We are no more on my local machine. Let's test this again with this public IP, hello world. And if you go on the same URL, but we add users, we have the same response. Now we want to create a Postman collection to test these APIs using Docker containers. Let's create a new collection. How can we create a new collection? I'm here in a public workspace. I can click collection, and we can create a new collection. If you already have one, you can click create new. Let's give a name to this collection, Postman Docker. And we can add a new request, for example, this one, hello world. So this will be renamed hello world. And let's add the other one. Right click, add request. Let's rename this as get users. Same URL, but with slash users. And you can let's send. Perfect. Let's save these two requests. And let's also add a very simple test for both the requests. So here I can click on tests. This one, status code, code is 200. You see here, we can add this on the hello world request, click save, and on the get users. Now we can try this Postman collection in Postman first, run collection. As you can see here, run Postman. Postman Docker is the name of the collection. And as you can see here, we have the two requests. To test this application using containers, we can just export this collection. This can be done using a JSON file or using a URL. We will use a JSON file on this video. Right click, export, collection version 2.1. It's okay, export. And we can export this in any folder we want. Let's call this Postman test. This will save it in a JSON format file, but we don't add any extension here. Click save. Postman-test is the name of the collection. Your collection was exported successfully. And now what? Because now we want to test this collection using containers. And to do this, we will use postman/newman, which is a command line collection runner for Postman, but we will run this using containers. This is really fascinating. We can use this on our machine or even on the Play with Docker instance. Let's do this on our machine, on the terminal. On Windows, you have to use command prompt or PowerShell, and we can use this command, docker run -v to add a volume. Then we need to add the path of our collection. Postman collection test is my folder. I can copy paste this one, /etc/newman-t/postman-newman-run. We are using the run for the Postman Newman, which also has a run. Don't confuse this with Docker run. And the name of the collection, which was Postman test. Okay. And as you can see here, we have the same test with the two GET requests. If I click here, I get the response here and this one. Perfect.